Well, there's a class called The Power of Whiteness. I have not taken that, but...
So what are some of like the big liberal arguments being forwarded on your campus? Like, what do you face every day? Is it like environmentalism? Is it like redistribution of wealth? Like, what are the big issues on your campus?
Multiculturalism is a big issue. And there's this institute called the Feinstein Institute, and they run like global studies as like major, and like a lot of my friends have dropped the major because they were so uncomfortable with how liberal it was. And there's a major called public and community service studies, which it sounds like nice on paper, but it's just very... It's not conservative at all. It's very liberal. It's very kind of out of place almost at the college compared to a lot of other majors. Like our economics department is very conservative, and philosophy is pretty conservative. Theology, obviously, but
right.
It's like we have this like one segment, and like sociology too is very liberal, and right. Political science has a nice mixture of everything.
But what are they? Do you have any good examples of what they teach on campus?
Well, there's a class called The Power of Whiteness. I have not taken that, but just it doesn't sound that great. I had a friend who took a class, it was like, I can't even remember, she was like horrified by how a teacher like vilified Ronald Reagan like the first class, and she ended up dropping to take a different class. I think that was in global studies actually, that department, but I'm political science, I have a libertarian professor right now, he's awesome, I love him, but he's not very popular among his colleagues,
right.
But he's nice to me, so I'll be nice to him back.
So what are some of the ideas you use to combat some of these forces on campus? I mean, you're at a conservative Christian university.
Yeah.
And so what are you trying to forward on campus? Like, what ideas are you trying to get out there?
I just want to get people active, because, like, a lot of people are very socially conservative on my campus, like, very pro-life, very traditional marriage, just, like, solid Catholic values. But they don't want to ever do anything, because they're, like, it's kind of like a silent majority, like, personified, which is a little frustrating as a student leader. And I just want to get people active and, like, more involved, going to conferences like this, and... I'm hopefully bringing a group of people down to CPAC, so that'll be fun, just to show them like what the conservative movement actually is, and like, hopefully everything works out. I just want to get people involved, not just like sit back and watch things get taken away from them.
Now, has Young America's Foundation been a good facilitator for you on campus?
Oh, definitely. Like, they've sent us a lot of posters and a lot of materials and pamphlets and stuff, and a lot of good ideas, like Berlin Wall, and like we did the 9/11 Never Forget project, which was really fun. Like, a lot of people were like really impressed
with your administration. Did they ever like try to put any roadblocks in, or was there like any sort of weird hesitance on some of your events?
Well, they thought our Berlin Wall was a little violent. They didn't really like our plan to use, we had originally planned to use drywall and sledgehammers, like the YAF website said. But we instead were forced to use cardboard. She suggested styrofoam as an environmentally friendly alternative, which I just don't understand.
Wait, back up a second. So they wanted you to use cardboard, and what was the hammering device that they had you use?
She never really suggested like a hemp device. We use wiffleball bats, which, I mean, it was
fun. You went from, at the beginning, you planned to use sledgehammers and like drywall, which
yeah.
is pretty picturesque and awesome.
Yeah.
And you go to wiffleball bats and cardboard? Is that like the PC way of celebrating the fall of the Berlin Wall? Do they think that they use wiffleball bats at the Berlin Wall?
I mean, apparently. I mean, I'd rather have a cardboard wall than no wall, so.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah.
Well, so were you a little bit shocked?
Not really. I mean, I kind of, they've given us trouble with events before, but I'm just glad that they actually like let us do something as opposed to nothing, so I'm glad we had at least something, and like people like painted on stuff on it that had no idea what the Berlin Wall even was, which is kind of sad, but.
Well, that's history classes for you, huh?
I know, right?